what's going on, guys? Welcome back to the channel. Thank you so much for being here. Hope that you're having a lovely one. I appreciate you showing up. You know, some of you show up all the time, some of you show up once the time. But seriously, like, regardless, I just appreciate you being here. Hope that you enjoy the music alongside me. Maybe you find something new that you never heard before and you enjoy it. But what we're going to do today is move on in Pink Moon, Nick Drake, 1972. Quite a while back, we had listened to the first two tracks on the album, so we're just going to move on to the next two tracks on the album. If you don't mind, and I'm sure you don't, that's going to be the tracks Road and Which Will. I have a silly question. You know how, I don't know, but you know, like, when you're a kid and, like, you're watching cartoons, they always say, like, the moon was made of cheese and stuff like that. Did anyone else as a kid think that the moon was actually made of cheese? I legitimately thought, like, for a while, for an embarrassing amount of time, that the moon was made of cheese because all these cartoons and stuff were saying it. I don't even know what to say. I don't know what type of cheese. I don't know. Anyways, let's go ahead and get into the music. I'll probably stop it after Road, talk about it, and then we'll move on to the next track, Which Will. So let's go ahead and get into it. Road, Nick Drake. Let's go. You know what I like about that? Because of the intimacy of Nick Drake, the production, of course, the guitar, it's really just those three things, the air, the atmosphere surrounding everything. I like how when you really concentrate on it and you're listening, the guitar has such a beautiful rhythmic pattern to it. I don't know how hard it is to play what he's playing. I really don't know. It could be the simplest thing ever, or it could be very complicated. I have no idea. I'm not a guitarist. But regardless of how complex or simple it is, it sounds at least rhythmically dense, melodically. It has some depth to it. And I like the dryness with which it's played. It's very mellow, but there's a stark way that it's being played. It's almost like a very monochromatic scheme that's being laid out before us, like a very beautiful painting. And then slowly, through his singing, which is also a bit monochromatic, little splashes, and I do mean like little splashes of color, are added to the palette. I just really like that. I was really concentrating on his guitar playing, and you know, there's not many words that are being sung, but the words that are said typically have some relevance, obviously. So we're going to get into that in a little bit. But I really like his guitar playing. There's something about it that's intimately inviting, I think is the best way I can put that, and how I felt like listening to this song. It's intimately inviting. Like, he's inviting us to listen in onto his thoughts at their most pure and at their most open and naked and vulnerable. Kind of like a Joni Mitchell in that regard. just so evocative and so emotional. You can say the sun is shining if you really want to. I can see the moon and it seems so clear. You can take a road that takes you to the stars now. I can take a road that'll see me through. I can take a road that'll see me through. And then that's repeated. So let's take this, right? The song title, Road. You can say the sun is shining if you really want to. I can see the moon and it seems so clear. You can say that everything is hunky-dory, to give a little David Bowie. You can say that everything is going just fine. You can say that there's light at the end of the tunnel in a good way. You can say that there's hope at the end of this. You can say that all you want, but you're being a little bit idealistic. He says, I can see the moon and it seems so clear. There's still light. There's still light. He's not saying it's a hopeless situation. The moon does give off light. But at night, there's some realities that perhaps we need to face. There is a darkness that we need to face. It's not just all sunshine and flowers, you know? So instead of fantasizing and just hoping that everything turns out all right, let's recognize the realities, see the goal at the end, see the light still, and work our way there. He's saying, I think, that he has a more realistic view, perhaps, of what's happening. You can take a road that takes you to the stars now. I can take a road that'll see me through. He's saying this other person can take a road that is so high and so lofty that, you know, when I think of taking the higher road, like, you can do that. I'm just trying to make it through. Once again, I'm being realistic. I'm just trying to see myself through this. I'm not trying to necessarily gain anything, make myself feel any better, make anyone else around me feel better. I'm just trying to get through this thing, whatever it may be. This road, so to speak. I like that. There's only, like, basically 5 lines in the song, because the other 4 are just repeated a second time. There's 4 lines. So much can be said from just those 4 lines. Let's go ahead and get into the next track here, which is going to be Which Will. Let's go.
Thank you.
once again, I'm listening to how Drake just plays the guitar so excellently, and his voice is just the perfect accompaniment, the perfect familiar to carry this ghostly melody along. Like, very, very beautiful combination. And once again, I'm just listening to the guitar, which is almost played in this very stoic, romanticized, self-reflective way. That it's just so poetic, I think. And I noticed something when I was listening to his voice, specifically in this song. Usually his singing is very low-key. And I was thinking about the way he was singing in almost these relaxingly hushed tones. Very direct. Very speaking to us. Speaking to you and to the listener. And you know what it made me think of? It made me think of, this is the same way that a father would sing or speak to his child. The same way that perhaps they would sing a lullaby to their child right before they go to sleep to help them go to sleep. It's very comforting. It's very paternal. It can be maternal, of course. I'm just saying paternal because it's Nick Drake. But I think that's part of the beauty of it. And that's what I mean when I speak of the intimacy. That's what I mean when I speak of the intimacy here. It's that closeness, it's that personality, or that personability, I should say, that makes me, when I'm listening to this, feel like I'm listening to a father just speaking to his son. And that's just from the tone of the way that Drake is singing. Which will you go for? Which will you love? Which will you choose from the stars above? Which will you answer? Which will you call? Which will you take for your one and all? And tell me now, which will you love the best? Now, can I tell you, I don't know anything about Drake or Nick Drake, like personal. You know, I don't know any personal things about him. So I don't know, but even looking at the lyrics, which I didn't really notice before, it could still be a parent talking to their kid, like their young child. Just looking at them and thinking of all the possibilities that they have in life, all the choices that they make. And you can imagine the parent just looking at them and just thinking to themselves, like, what will you do? Will you do this? Will you do that? Will you do... The possibilities are endless. And the parent is going to be there to help them to further whatever roads they want to take in life. And to help them and encourage them and inspire them. Which do you dance for? Which makes you shine? Which will you choose now if you won't choose mine? Which will you hope for? What? Which can it be? Which will you take now if you won't take me? And tell me now, which will you love the best? That's beautiful. And I'm just thinking the parental idea, but this could also be romantic. This could be in other ways. But I just think that's incredibly beautiful. That's, once again, a very intimate song. That's just what I'm getting from it. I know I keep using the word, but intimacy is really what I'm feeling from this. And the other track as well with Rhodes. Let me know what you guys thought of these two tracks, though. You can let me know in the comments below. Let me know, by the way, is the guitar playing hard, or is it just kind of... It's pretty simple, but maybe it's the way that Drake is playing it that seems a little more dense than usual. Like, in a good way. It's still airy. There's still air in it, but it's still kind of a woody density to it. I don't know. But let me know what you guys thought. Comments, follow me on Twitter, on Patreon, all those places. Hope you enjoyed the music. Thank you as always for being here, and I'll see you guys later. Bye.